isn't God good? Hallelujah. Has God done anything good for anybody this week? If he has, won't you just stand up on your feet and give God praise? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For this is the day that the Lord has made. And he has made it that we be glad and rejoice in it. Anybody glad today? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord. For his mercy is good. And it lasts from generation to generation. Put your hands together and join in with the choir as they minister to us this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, choir and minister.
can't trace him, hold on. When you can't see your way, hold on. You got to hold on through all your trials. You got to hold on through all your tribulation. I said, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on. Don't give up. Don't give in. There's victory in the end. Hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on. Be your hope.
Y'all wake up this morning. Y'all mighty quiet out there. And it reads, hear me when I call, O God of my righteousness. Thou hast enlarged me when I was in distress. Have mercy upon me and hear my prayer. O ye sons of men, how long will ye turn my glory into shame? How long will ye love vanity and seek after leasing? But know that the Lord has set apart him that is godly for himself. The Lord will hear when I call unto him. Stand in awe and sin not. Commune with your own heart upon your bed and be still. Offer the sacrifices of righteousness and put your trust in the Lord. That there may many say, who will show us any good? Lord, lift thou up thy light of thy countenance upon us. Thou hast put gladness in our hearts, mm-hmm. more than in the time that the corn and the wine increase. I will both lay me down in peace and sleep, for thou, O Lord, only maketh me to dwell in safety. Hallelujah. Isn't God good?
Hallelujah.
We will now have prayer by Deacon Cotton Brown.
First of all, good morning. Hopefully you had a blessed and wonderful Thanksgiving and you got your shop on until you couldn't stand anymore. I know it's rainy outside, but praise be to God. There's sunshine on the inside. And I woke up this morning in great anticipation and excited about what today would bring. Today is a momentous day. The Lord has continually shown himself strong. He's kept us in the midst of many storms, trials, tribulations. And he's brought us to this blessed and wonderful day. Holy Spirit is here, resonating within our hearts. My. God has been so good. When you look back over your life, I don't know about you, but I don't look like what I've been through. But God has been so good. And I dare not praise his holy name. We don't want our living and our praise. To the throne of grace. Eternal God, our Father, thank you for this day. A day which we've never seen before, and a day which we shall never see again. From the rising of the sun until the going down of the same, you're God. And Father God, we just want to thank you for touching us early this morning, giving us the movement of our limbs, and the articulation of speech, and allowing us to come to your house one more time. Dear God, we thank you for keeping us as we've been tossed, as we've been driven, as we've been pressed on every side. But praise be to God, you've continued to show yourself strong. Father God, we just want to thank you for touching our minds, causing us to reflect on your tender grace, your tender mercy, and your wonderful and saving keeping power. Dear God, we ask that you forgive us of our sins, sins of commission as well as omission, that you would cast them on the sea of forgetfulness as far as the east is from the west. And that being done, dear God, we want to praise your holy and righteous name. You've been a good God. You've been a kind God. You've been better to us than we've been to ourselves. And Father God, we ask that you would energize us, dear God, that you would touch us from the crowns of our heads to the soles of our feet, that we will give you the honor, that we will give you the glory, and that we will give you the praise. For we have a mind for the fact that when the praises go up, the blessings come down. And dear God, you certainly have not been remiss in blessing us. And we just want to thank you, Lord, because you didn't have to do it, but you did. And we are so thankful. We are so grateful. And Father God, we ask that you would touch our pastor-elect and our associate ministers as we move forward today as a pastor, as a people, pressing on to our homeward journey. Father God, we realize full well that this world is not our home, but you are preparing us, dear God, for that home on high, where every day will be Sunday and Sabbath will have no end. Father God, touch those who have suffered sickness, loss, bereavement. We ask that you touch Taylor Williamson and thank you for that agape love that you gave us. For we have a mind for the fact that love covers a multiplicity of sin. Strengthen us, dear God, that we will radiate love in this cruel and difficult age. Father God, bless those who are assembled here today. Bless those who are yet on the way. Bless those who have the desire to be in the midst, but for some reason could not be here. And dear God, we ask you to touch those who are tuned in virtually, dear God. For we realize that you are God who is everywhere at the same time, sitting high, looking low, the administrator of every good and perfect gift. Dear God, but most of all, we want to thank you for your darling son, Jesus, who came into this world, who bled, suffered, and died. And because Jesus lives, we can live also. And we want to thank you for Jesus putting us in right relationship with his Father. And because Jesus lives, we know where we're headed when this life ends. Father God, strengthen us that we will be prepared for that day, that we will run this race, that one day, dear God, we will stand before thee, where we will hear these words, well done, thou good and faithful servant, you have been faithful over a few things, now come on up, and I'll make you ruler over many things, enter thou to the joy of the Lord. These and other blessings we ask in thy darling son Jesus' name. And because of him, we can continually pray. Amen and hallelujah.
upward way. New heights I'm gaining every day. Bye.
God. How many people are witnesses that God can pick you up? He can turn you around. He can place your feet on solid ground, on higher ground. How many people are witnesses that if God didn't do that for you, that you wouldn't be who you are or where you are today? Hallelujah, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Ooh. Have your way, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. We will now have the welcome. Are any visitors here today? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If there is anyone on Facebook or out there on the radio for the first time, we certainly thank God and thank you all for coming to join us. We here at Third Baptist Church, is our motto that by love we serve one another. And we really do love each other. We're not saying that we are perfect, but we are saying it's by Jesus Christ that our love is being perfected day by day. And that any time that the doors of Third Baptist Church are open, you are always welcome. And we pray, it's our prayer, that something will be said and done here today that would just bless your soul. And we here at Third Baptist have a way of showing our love and our thanks for you coming. But we will ask that you will stand up and open your arms to receive it. Come on, Third Baptist. Let's show our visitors some love. On the count of three. One, two, three. Thank you, and we pray that this won't be your last time here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Our announcements for today. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. The following are our announcements for the 26th of November, 2023. Our radio broadcast can be heard on FM 103.1. This afternoon at 2 o'clock, we, the members of Third Baptist Church, will install our pastor-elect, Reverend Cassandra Bullock. Reverend Dr. Travis Warren and the Spring Hill Baptist Church family will be our guests, and they will be in charge of the service. Please come and join us as we give God all the glory for this blessed occasion. Wednesday night Bible study will resume December the 6th at 6 p.m. On December the 17th, we will be judging our ugly sweater contest. If you are interested in participating, the points of contact are Reverend Brenda Cherry, Brother Deontay Grandison, Sister Dee Taylor, and Deacon McCallum. Prayers and condolences are extended to the Hobbs, the Taylor, the Williamson family, at the homegoing of their loved one, Sister Marva Hobbs, and all who have suffered sickness, loss, or bereavement. But I pray that you would also just continue to keep those in prayers who are homeless, who have no food on the table. Hallelujah. There's plenty of people going through stuff. And bereavement is one, but I know there are plenty of people who are suffering from homelessness right now. So please keep them, lift them up in prayer also. Amen. Amen. And let us continue to pray for our church family, our community, and the rest of this world. These are our announcements and notices for today. Now, church family, what time is it? It is offering time. Deacons and ushers, please take charge.
Father God, bless this offering. Multiply it 10, 20, 100-fold. Bless the giver, Father God, but a special blessing for those who could not give, that they may be able to give next time, Father God. In Jesus Christ's name, let us all say, amen.
Certainly thank God for all that has been said and done thus far. We even thank God for his presence, just stopping by here just for a little while. Hallelujah. But now it is preaching time. And our speaker for the day would be none other than our very own Reverend Brenda Cherry. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So today I would just say, just point your right hand towards Reverend Cherry and say, Reverend Cherry, just preach the word. Reverend Cherry, preach the word. In season or out of season, whether they like it or not, you just preach the word. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. The next voice after the choir that you would hear would be our very own Reverend Brenda Cherry. Hallelujah.
What's the matter with Jesus?
About y'all. But when I hung out at the mousetrap, I did my thing. I ain't care who saw it and whether Leroy Cherry liked it or not. I did my boogie. I got my dance on. Y'all don't know what I talk about, do you? You don't know what you missed either. I thank and praise God for today, for this opportunity to stand for him one more time. A wonderful day and a historical day, because this is the day that Third Baptist Church will install their first female pastor. Thank you, Lord. You may be seated. Woo. Thank you, Lord. Glorious occasion. Thank you, God. Our scripture, Psalm 121, verses 1 to 4. Psalm 121, verses 1 to 4. And it reads, I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills. From whence cometh my help? My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall never, neither slumber nor sleep. Let us pray. We thank you, dear God, for another opportunity to stand and declare your wonderful word. I pray, Heavenly Father, that thou will use me to your glory. And I'll give you all glory, honor, and praise. Let the words of my mouth and meditations of my heart be acceptable in your sight. In Jesus' name, I do pray. Amen. Ooh, Lord. Our thought today, stress, but still blessed.
Well, well.
Stressed.
Yeah.
But still blessed. Psalm 121 is a part of a group of psalms, namely Psalms 120 to 134, which are written by David and referred to as songs of degree, accent psalms, or pilgrim songs that were sung by the Jewish people traveling uphill to Jerusalem for one of the three main festivals that God had commanded of them. The theme of this psalm is God's care of his people. In it, David assures himself of help from God and for others. As he climbed upward the hill, David proclaimed that the Lord, who created the heavens and earth, was his sole source of help. David believed that no matter what happened in his life, that all of his help would come from the Lord. Brothers and sisters, this is a word of encouragement, an example for us to follow. That no matter how stressed David may have been, he was confident that God would always stand by his side. He trusted and believed the promises of God. God delivered him in troubled times, and he knew that God would never fail him. He believed that as long as God was on his side, everything would be all right. Anybody know what I'm talking about? You know when it feels like trouble comes and knocks the wind out of your sails, or when you feel your back is up against a wall and you can't see your way, or you don't know which way to turn, or the times you learn the hard way that everybody that laughed and grinned in your face ain't your friend. Times when it seems like the more you do, the more you have to do. Or when you take two steps up, you're knocked 10 steps back. It's then that we should look toward the hill, knowing that our help doesn't come from the hills, but from the one who created the hills. The Life Application Bible teaches that this psalm expresses assurance and hope in God's protection day and night, and that we should never trust anyone but God for absolute protection. We should be mindful that our God is all-powerful, all-knowing, and everywhere at the same time. We can go to him 24/7 whenever the need arises, whether it's stress or distress, oppressed, depressed, affliction, troubles, grief, heartache, or worriedness. We can always take it to God in prayer. No problem is too great that God can't solve. No burden too heavy that he can't bear. No storm too rough that he can't calm. God can shut doors no man can open, and open doors no man can shut. We've all heard the phrase, too blessed to be stressed. And all it simply means is to change our focus from the problems and think about the goodness of God and all he has done for us. It doesn't mean we won't have problems or be anxious about anything. Sure, we might get stressed, but glory be to God, we are still blessed. In verse 3, you may ask, what does it mean he will not allow your foot to be moved? God is promising us that circumstances that cause us to move around against our will not befall us. Nothing shall move our feet against our will. God will protect us. The Lord keeps the feet of his saints from falling. He will not suffer them to be moved out of the spiritual estate in which they stand, nor off of the foundation and rock of ages of which the feet are set and their goings established, nor out of the house of God. Verse 4 says, he who keep Israel would neither slumber nor sleep. This portrays God as the guardian of Israel, who never rests from his care of his people. While we sleep, God is alert and watchful. He's always right there with us. And if it's by some chance that anybody feels far from God, guess who moved? Not God, because he's immutable. He never changes. He's El Roi. He watches over all of us at all times. Brothers and sisters, stress ain't no joke. It can break you down and cause big problems. Stress can take you out. But thanks be to God, we can find consolation in troubled times in his word, such as in Philippians 4, 6, and 7, that says, do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Probably one of the best known passages on anxiety comes from the Sermon on the Mount in Matthew 6. Our Lord warns us against being anxious about the various cares of life. Jesus said, therefore I tell you, do not be anxious about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, nor about your body or what you will put on. Is life not more than food and the body more than clothing? There are others in the Bible who had problems with their anxiety, like Queen Esther, who was preparing to see the king and was anxious because she was planning to risk her life on behalf of her people. Or Hannah, who was distressed because she was unable to conceive and was being taunted by Peninnah, her husband's other wife. Or Paul, who had a thorn in his flesh and went to God 3 times, but God had other plans. He said, my grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. Brothers and sisters, again I say, stress will take you out, cause your blood pressure to shoot up, and it can happen to the best of us. But again, that's the time we need to be looking towards the hills from whence cometh our help, to the one who's able to do all things but fail. We got to remember that we grow through what we go through. We got to remember that the enemy will do all he can to block us. And even though we might be stressed, brothers and sisters, we are still blessed. Jesus teaches us. Our Heavenly Father knows our needs and our cares. Health problems, pressure, troubles, family problems, money problems, discords and disagreements in churches can cause stress. That child or that mate or friend that won't do right, all can cause stress. But rather than worry over things we can't control, we should seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And all these things, the necessities of life, will be taken care of. Putting God first will strengthen us. to face whatever comes our way. In closing, this psalm identifies God's confidence in him only. It identifies God as Elohim, the creator of heaven and earth. David knew firsthand that God helps, protects, shields, and delivers. It teaches us to comfort ourselves in the Lord when difficulties and dangers are great. Calls for those who put themselves in God's divine protection will appreciate knowing that they are safe in his arms. David learned to encourage himself in troubled times, and we too can count on the Lord to provide our needs, protect us from evil, guide us, and keep our souls secure for eternity. We may not be able to prevent certain things or anxious thoughts from entering our minds, but we can practice the right kind of response. We might have storms to rise, troubles to come, conflicts may happen, our bodies may get sick, and stressfulness may surge. But no matter what comes our way, we can still proclaim, I'm blessed. We can sing because we are happy, because his eye is on the sparrow, and we know he watches over us. Another old song says, when upon life's billows I am tempted and tossed, I can count my blessings and see what God has done. Jesus prayed 3 times to avoid the cross in the Garden of Gethsemane. Yeah. He undoubtedly experienced anxiety over the torture and horrifying death that awaited him. But he also understood the greater agony that he would experience in bearing the sins for us. Yeah. He was not rebelling against his Father's will when he asked that the cup of suffering and separation be taken away. In fact, he reaffirmed his desire to do God's will by saying, nevertheless, not as I will, but as thy will. His prayers revealed his terrible suffering. His suffering was worse than death that he paid for our sins. And even though he suffered immensely, he knew what awaited him, and he went on anyhow. And he went with us on his mind. He became one of us. He expressed the natural human desire to avoid pain and suffering. They hung him high and they stressed him wide. They forced their crown of thorns on his brow. He endured the torment, suffered the cruel and inhumane torture of crucifixion for 6 agonizing hours, all for us. And now he sits on the right hand of the Father, making intercession for us. I know he cares for me. And God, I thank you. I'm grateful that I can still look towards the hill for whence cometh my help, because I know where my help comes from. I'm grateful for all that he has done for me. I'm grateful that we have someone watching over us and sees our going out and our coming in. I'm grateful that when times get rough, I can go to the rock. I can go to the rock of my salvation. I can turn to God because I know God is able. He's able to do all things but faith. I ain't worried about tomorrow because I know who holds tomorrow. And I know who holds my hand. No matter how hard times get, I know where to go. I know what to say. I know what to preach. I know what to shout. That even though I'm stressed, glory be to God. Even though I'm stressed, glory be to God. Even though I'm stressed, glory be to God. I am still blessed. No matter what goes on our lives.
still blessed.
Yeah.
We are here this morning, ain't we? And still blessed. Trouble might come, but we still blessed.
Yeah.
The doctor may give us some bad news, but we still blessed. Might not have money to pay them bills, but we still blessed.
Yeah.
When folk don't act right, some won't get right, and the rest don't care. I am still blessed. Christian experience or watch care, or if you have fallen or just taken a back seat, come on and be reinstated and grow closer to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. While the choir sings, won't you come? Reverend Brenda Cherry, for that wonderful message and that wonderful reminder, that even when we are stressed, we are still blessed. And we have someone who we can call on no matter the day, the minute, or the hour. We don't have to be put on hold. We don't have to wait for a call back. We can just take it to Jesus and leave it there. And if there be one today that want to come to the altar, to leave your cares, whatever it is, at the altar so that God can take care of it. Why not put it in his hand? He holds the entire world in his hand. There's no need for you to keep it. No need for you to internalize it. No need for you to keep taking it back through that front, back door, side door. But leave it at the altar right now. Or just bring your praise to the altar. Because God has been so good to you this week that you just want to tell him thank you. Thanking you for bringing you to the house of worship one more time. Thank you, Lord, for just saving my soul. Won't you come at this time? Our hearts and minds on one accord. We may have different situations and different circumstances, but we are on one accord that we're going to leave it at the altar. We're going to give it to God, and we're not going to take it back from him. Let him hold you. Let him keep you. Let him protect you. Father God, we come to you, just a few of your people. Lord God, just thanking you for another day's journey. Thanking you, Lord, for just being who you are. Thanking you, Lord, for just sending a Savior for a sinner like me. Lord God, I just thank you for Jesus Christ that came down 42 generations. Lord God, they hung him high and they stretched him wide. For each and every one of us, he died. And for that, Lord, we say thank you. Lord God, if there's been anything said or done that is not pleasing to thee, Father God, right now we ask that you, Lord God, that you just take it, Lord God, and drown it in that river of Jordan that will never rise to trouble us no more. In the name of Jesus. And so, Father God, right now, we're going to ask, Lord, that there are those that are among us, Lord God, that have been sick. So, God, right now, we're going to claim the victory of healing over their body. Right now, in the name of Jesus, that every ache and pain, every disease has been removed. Father God, every ill feeling, every hurt, every scratch, every fever is gone. In the name of Jesus, we count it gone right now, Lord God. And Father God, there are some of us who are in need of something, Lord God. But God, we know that you are a God of provision, Lord God. Father God, when we think we just don't have anywhere to turn, Father God, you have placed a ram in our bush. So God, right now, we're holding on to that ram. We're grabbing a hold of his ears. We're grabbing a hold of his feet, Lord God, because we know that your name is Jehovah Jireh, our provider. So God, whatever it is that someone is standing in need of today, Lord God, whatever it is, financial, socially, economically, material, mentally, God, physically, whatever it is, Lord God, we know that you can give it to us. So God, right now, some of us just want to say thank you. Thank you for waking us up. Thank you for food on our table. Thank you for clothes on our back. Thank you, Lord God, for what you've done. And thank you for what you're going to do. And Father God, for those that are bereaved right now, Lord God, some of us miss our loved one that is not here to share the holidays with us. Lord God, right now we know that you can give us all for joy for the period of mourning. You can give us a garment of praise, Lord God, so that we may stand tall like trees of righteousness. Lord God, so we say thank you, Lord God. We thank you for how you love us and keep us. Lord God, we thank you for how you protect us day in and day out. So Father God, for those that have asked for prayer, Sister Lyons and Sister Marla, Lord God, Hobbs, Lord God, we just ask and gives, Lord God, we just ask, Lord God, for Edna Burroughs, Lord God, we just say thank you, Lord God. Woo! Thank you, Lord God. Sister Faye Jackson, who has asked for a special prayer. Lord God, right now, Evelyn Jones, we just lift you up, Lord God. Father God, we just thank you for each and every household that is represented. Anoint from the top of the head to the soles of their feet. And every person that one is standing in the gap for, Lord God, just be with them right now. Touch Sister Carolyn Coleman, Lord God, be with them. Lord God, we ask that you be with her right now in the name of Jesus. And all of our Facebook and YouTube listeners. For it is in Jesus' name. It's in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name that I pray on behalf of your people. And let us all say amen, amen, and amen. Hallelujah, God. And now as we leave this place but never his side, may the love of God, the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit, rest, rule, and abide henceforth, now and forevermore. Let us all say we are too blessed to be stressed. Go in victory. See you at 2 o'clock.